am I? Who am I? One of the most prominent questions that I'm asked all the time by people in the prisons who do not know who they are. They're lost. They have tried everything of this world. They've tried every self-help book. They've tried gurus, fortune tellers. They've tried psychiatric stuff, mental help. They've tried, cultural things. They've tried everything of this world. Still don't know who they are. Life's still a wreck. They don't know why. They do not know what's the secret sauce, right? What's the secret sauce? That is why we go into prisons, guys, to help liberate the minds of people, men and women, who are enslaved to the enemy, who blinds the minds of unbelievers to keep them from the light of the gospel and the glory of Christ, okay, who is the image of God, to help free them by giving them the truth and replacing it, or giving them the truth to replace the lie that's in their mind. So who am I? Listen, this is an identity issue, okay? It's an identity crisis, literally, okay? If you do not, you will never know who you are unless you know whose you are. Okay, let me say that again, all right? You will never know who you are unless you know whose you are, okay? Because someone purposefully and intentionally created you with reason and purpose and value and intentionality, that if you don't receive the identity that that person says of you, then you will believe a lie your whole entire life and it'll control everything about you. Perfect example. In the Garden of Eden, okay, when Adam and Eve disobeyed, right? The enemy came and talked to them, hey, you'll be just like God. You won't die. They're like, oh, okay. I guess I'll eat of the fruit and be just like God then. They ate of the fruit, they disobeyed, and boom, sin came into the world, right? They believed a lie about God and themselves, and it wrecked their lives. It's wrecked all of our lives. That's what Satan does. That's what lies do, guys. And he's after your identity. And the reason that he's after your identity is because he hates God. And when he can't hurt God, he goes after God's image. We're made in the image of God, so he attacks us. And he doesn't want us to be confident in our lives, and he doesn't want us to be free, and he doesn't want us to be liberated. And so he attacks our identity. He gets us to believe that, you know, all different kinds of lies about ourselves, guys. So look, here's the thing, right? We have to believe what the image bearer embedded in us when he created us, the image, okay, and our identity that he gave us. Not what the world says, not what your mother says, not what, you know, somebody at your school says, not what a bully says, not what culture says, not what, you know, society says, but what the Creator says about you, right? He says that you are holy, you are righteous, you are redeemed, you are a saint, you are set apart, you are a child of God, you have been seated in the heavenly places with Christ. He says that you have been made new. All things have passed away. You are brand new. You are no longer who you once were. You now have love, joy, peace, patience, goodness, kindness, gentleness, self-control. You have the ability to forgive. You have the ability to love. You see, you're no longer who you once were. And if you don't believe that stuff about you, that God says about you, you're going to be lost your whole entire life. You're going to suffer your whole entire life. You're going to hurt your entire life. And you're going to believe a lie. And the lie is going to send you off into wherever it sends you. You're just going to be lost in life. But look, okay, there is a but, okay? And the but is this. We must receive the Holy Spirit, okay? We must be born again. We must. And here's the reason why, okay? In order for us to be able to understand the wisdom of God, we must have the mind of God, the mind of Christ. And in order to have the mind of Christ, we must receive the Spirit of Christ. Because where the Spirit of the Lord is, where the Spirit of Christ is, there is freedom. And in order for us to be free and believe what God says about us and us understand who we are, we must receive the Holy Spirit, okay? And it's so that God can do his work in us, okay? So that he can start washing and renewing our minds by the Holy Spirit and through the power of the Word, right? That's why we read the Bible. So look, guys, if you don't have the Holy Spirit, the good news is that you can right now. All you have to do is this, Lord, I'm sorry. Forgive me of my sins, God. I repent. God, I want to know you, Lord, but most of all, I want to know my identity. I want to know who I am in you, Lord. Give me the confidence in you, Lord. Give me assurance in you, Lord. Give me hope. God, help me today. Boom, there you go, guys. You can start your relationship with the Lord, and He will start giving you knowledge and wisdom and letting you know who He is, and He'll start letting you know who you are. And it's baby steps, guys. Baby steps with the Lord, okay? But you'll grow and you'll mature and it'll turn into big things, okay? So look, our identity is important, okay? Who am I? You are the Lord's. You are God's, intentionally created by an intelligent being who loves you beyond what you can imagine. And He has given you your identity. And we must believe that identity and what He says about us in order for us to be free and not enslaved to the enemy and to this world. So, read the Word, pray, and let's do it, guys, okay? Because God is ready to do a good work in you. Behold, he's ready to do a new thing. He wants to do a new thing in you and every single person that's willing. All right, God doesn't hold back. He's not sitting up there like, oh man, should I save this guy? No, He wants to save you. He wants to save you. Talk to Him. Tell Him you're sorry. Begin your relationship with Him today. Let Him put in you your identity so that you will no longer be lost, guys. Listen, I was enslaved to alcohol for 28 years of my life. Okay, I believe the whole AA stuff. Every time you go into AA group, you say, hello, my name's Ryan, I am an alcoholic. Let me tell you something, I was an alcoholic until Christ came into my life and He said, hello, your name is Ryan, you are free. Jesus Christ sets the captives free. John 8:36, okay? Who the Son sets free is free indeed. And Romans 8, chapter 1 and 2, okay? Christ came to set us free from sin and death. You understand? Sin and death, okay? So I'm not an alcoholic. I'm free in Christ. And whatever it is that the enemy has you enslaved to, chained to, or bind to in this world, I can guarantee you it's a lie, because freedom comes in Christ. Give Christ your life and watch what He can do with you, because He loves you.